This is an M.2 SSD enclosure. I got it from Amazon. The brand is Bakel, but it comes also under other name brands. So I'm gonna open it and I'm gonna show you how to install this M.2 NVMe drive in it. And I'm gonna also tell you what are the compatible drives that this enclosure can take. So let's open it. This is a tool-free enclosure. You have a user guide. This is the enclosure. It feels really good. It is made from aluminum. So this is a silicon pad so that your M.2 drive doesn't heat up. USB-A to USB-C cable. And by the way, this is USB 3.2 gen. So it can go up to speeds of 10 gigabits per second. And this is USB-C to USB-C cable. About the compatibility of this M.2 enclosure with the drives. So it can take the M key drives and also it can take the B plus M keys, but it cannot take the B key drive. It opens like this, just press here and then slide it up. So also for the sizes of the M.2 drives, it can take many sizes. This is a 2280 size. So let me put these here. This is an additional buckle in case you have another size of M.2 drive here. But here I have the 2280 and it has also a buckle here. So this is how to install the drive. Just align the key with the key opening here, push it in gently. And then the buckle, if it is like this, turn it and then push the drive down gently. Make sure that it goes under the buckle like this and then turn it 180 degrees to hold the drive down. So now the buckle is holding the drive down and now you can put your silicon pad on the drive like this and then close it in case your drive gets hot. So this is what I'm gonna do. So I'm gonna remove the protection from the silicon pad, put on top of the drive here, and then remove the protection from the top. And this is the silicon pad installed. Make sure it is directly on the drive. And now turn it and slide it in the housing like this until it clicks in place. So now it is installed. I'm gonna connect it now to my PC on a 3.2 USB port. And then I'm gonna test the enclosure speed with this drive that is really very fast. So this is a Gen 4 drive that can go up to speed to 7,000 gigabits per second. So in no way it will be a bottleneck for the enclosure. So now I connected the enclosure to my PC and I will be performing three tests. The first two tests are to test the speed of the enclosure and the last test is to test if this enclosure dissipates the heat from the M.2 drive that is installed in it. So you see here on the screen two windows. The window on the bottom is my internal NVMe drive that is a Crucial P5 Plus that is really very fast, so it will not be a bottleneck for the external enclosure that has the TimeTech drive. So I'll be copying first a large file into the enclosure to see the theoretical speed that they advertise, which is 10 gigabits per second, which is approximately 1.25 gigabytes per second. So I'm expecting it to write the file in about 700, 800 megabytes per second. So let's see if it achieves the speed. And it is really very fast. So it's reaching 700 megabytes per second for a sequential file, which is really, really very good. So this is a 6.4 gigabytes file. So let me now copy it in the other way. So from the enclosure to the internal drive, and I'm expecting it to be really very fast here. So I'm gonna put it in this folder. And the speed was spectacular. Like the reading speed was almost 2.5 gigabytes per second. So now let's perform a real world test on this. So I'm gonna copy a series of photos and videos, and this is much more like representative of day-to-day use. So this is from the Crucial internal drive to the external NVMe enclosure. And it's really very good. So it's achieving speeds of 650, 670 megabytes per second. These are the videos. So now it will drop a little bit because these are the photos. They are smaller files and this is very normal, but the speed is really very good. So it achieved around 550 megabytes per second, which is great. So let's do the opposite test now. So reading from the NVMe enclosure and writing to the internal Crucial drive. And it is much faster with reading. So it's achieving like 850, 900 megabytes per second. and now it's dropping a little bit on the photos. So it achieved around like 790 megabytes per second, which is spectacular. So now I'm going to perform the last test. I will stress the drive that is in this M.2 enclosure to see the temperatures it reaches, so to see if this enclosure really can dissipate the heat of the drive. So to do this, I'm going to stress the drive with Crystal Disk Mark. By default, Crystal Disk Mark benchmark performs the same test 5 times using 1 gigabyte of sample data. So I'm going to increase the 1 gigabyte to 2 gigabytes, so to stress the drive more. So let's start the test. And while the test is running, I wanted to tell you that the TimeTech Pinnacle S1 drive that I'm using in this M.2 enclosure is made of graphene. And this is a new material that dissipates heat really very good. So I'm not expecting the drive to heat up in this enclosure. So now the test finished and the result of the temperature is really very good. So the drive didn't go beyond 43 degrees Celsius, which is excellent. And at the same time, we tested the performance of this M.2 enclosure, and you see that it is really very good. It is excellent. So it's giving all the performance that can be obtained from a USB drive. And of course, it is helped here by the excellent TimeTech Pinnacle S1 drive also. By the way, if you want to check out this external M.2 enclosure, I'm going to leave an Amazon affiliate link in the description below. If you make a purchase using my link, I will gain a small percentage at no cost to you, and this will help my channel. I want to thank you all for watching, and I hope that you enjoyed this video and you found it useful. In case you did, please share it, subscribe to my channel, and give this video a thumbs up. I'm Eloy from Knowledge Sharing Tech. See you in the next video.